I am here to make bear some issues arising from the crisis, international crisis, currently plaguing our union, Norway. There are two or three issues that I want to highlight. One is that the force of occupation at the National Secretariat of NULGE now are not the legally elected people to occupy the office. Because their second and final constitutional tenure expired on 24th March 2019. Despite that, they refused to vacate the office. Because on 16th October 2016, they conducted a special National Delegate Conference, during which they gave themselves 2 years extension of their tenure. Though it's against the Union Constitution, because there's no constitution for termination in our constitution. Some members of the Union went to court, and on 11th July 2019, the National Industrial Court over the division nullified technical limitation for all elected officers of the union. That is to say, all those people, all those elected officers whose tenure had expired must vacate the office immediately after that judgment. But our former national leadership refused to vacate the office. They said, they claimed that the judgment was spent for the litigants from Imo State who went to court to challenge the tenure limitation. So, and they also challenged the veracity of that judgment in Cardinal and Appellate Divisions of NICN. They claimed before the court that they were not affected by that judgment. That it is national officers and the state officers are not affected. Only the officers from Imo State were affected because they were the leaders. They started applying blackmail, outright falsehood, propaganda, intimidation, to cow to submission all the opponents of tenure and immigration. The National Caretaker Committee came into force on 29th July 2019 after the judgment of Abule. That is 11th July 2019. And the concern of there's a provision for the establishment of Caretaker Committee in case election could not be conducted in our constitution. And that was what we now rely upon to set up a National Caretaker Committee. We invited those people that were not affected by the judgment, because at that time, some state branches were still running their constitutional tenure, but they are very few in number. They are no more than nine. States that were not affected. We invited them to come and set up the Caretaker Committee. But because they wanted to enjoy the telelocation too, they refused to come. But that also did not stop us from going ahead with what we wanted to do. And that was, it was only Edo State that came because it was not affected by the telelocation. So, and we now set up that we also apply the doctrine of necessity because we invited delegates from all the state of federation, and all of them attended that summit where we set up the Caretaker Committee. We have records of the attendance and everything. So now set up the Caretaker Committee. It was there, the same Caretaker Committee headed by Comrade Nankpak Miri Njomiri was appointed as National Chairman chairman of the National Caretaker Committee and others, other members of the committee were drawn from six geopolitical zones of the country. And at that meeting, I was appointed as General Secretary of NULGE and also to serve as Secretary to the National Caretaker Committee. But these people refused to leave the office. We are subjected to a lot of intimidation and harassment. Police and other coup methods they applied to make us abandon the struggle. So since they refused to leave, we now went to court on 20 October 2020, asking court to give them another, to direct them to vacate the office because their tenure had expired on 24th March 2019. On 5th November 2020, they also went to court through their proxy, asking the court to restrain National Caretaker Committee from discharging the schedule of the Assembly Council of the Union. So, and it was granted. And through an ex parte order, it was granted. So, and it was done to cage the National Caretaker Committee from being functional, so that they will be able to do whatever they want to do without disturbance from any quarter. Because it's only the National Caretaker Committee that's giving them problems at the national and the state level. There were a lot of interventions. NSC, Federal Minister of Labor, and some other stakeholders. There were several interventions from NSC, Federal Minister of Labor, the Inspector General of Police, and other stakeholders asking us to bring our minimum terms of settlement. But our question is this: if gold should rust, what should iron do? If a tribunal will not abide by the rule of law, then there will be anarchy in the practice of tribunalism. So we said, let them abide by the union constitution that limits the tenure to two terms, and also obey the judgment and say that the extension you gave yourself is invalid and it has been nullified. So they are just playing around with something. And what the only body that whose action powerful does is that of NSC, NSC chairman, NSC president, Comrade Nankpak Miri. Each time we met with him, he gave us the impression that he's a pseudo-democrat. He just asked us to set aside the Union Constitution and the judgments to settle the matter. And we said, no, we cannot settle this matter outside the Union Constitution, because that's the judgment. Because these are the things that are guiding us. But he said we should find a political solution. But on that level, we saw some element of bias in him, and that was said to say, no, Agbawa can never midwife any settlement between us and the former national leadership. Because these same people, they know that they have judgments, we have cases in court that are pending in respect of the national leadership of the union. And they went ahead to conduct election on 6th January 2021 in Lagos. We drew the attention of National Industrial Court, the president of National Industrial Court of Abuja. We drew the attention of it, and he said we should apply to the court that is hearing our matter. That is Justice oh, by unaware. Because that was during the faculty. We said we should apply to him. We were now said, a matter that will be the election that will be conducted in 6th January. I said we should wait after the holiday. They will have conducted the election before we can do that. So, but you see that's the only way we can assist us. And from the outset, we suspected bias, and we also suspected miscarriage of justice. Because the two cases, the one we filed by some other members of the union, and the one filed by the former national leadership, were placed before the same judge, the honorable justice. And we wrote to the we approached the court that look, there are many judges in NIC Abuja. How can you give the same two cases to one lawyer, one judge? Give it to another judge because we don't expect anything, any fair treatment from a justice one way because he has done it before. August 8, 2019, the same. Honorable Justice Anoue granted ex parte order on the establishment of a judgment. In spite of the fact that he declined to establish the judgment, if you see the judgment, you see the judgment. He said he could not interpret the judgment, and at the same time went ahead to give order. So we say, if you say you cannot interpret, why are you now giving order? So, and this same matter, this interpretation they brought before Justice Anoue was also taken to Oweli, NIC Oweli, through motion notice, why they came to Justice Anoue through what do we call it? motion notice, the same day, 7th August, by the same person, Ayodele Ajiwoli, a NULGE official. But they have abandoned that of Owiri. Why they went ahead with that of because the man granted what they were asking for. So, to us, that this is dubious. So when the two matters are now taken before us, we believe that this woman will be biased. I will now approach NSP. Look, this woman cannot do justice to this matter because we suspected bias or whatever in the treatment of our matter. So the man refused to transfer the matter to another person. Even when the woman was sick, Justice Anoue was sick, the NIC president refused to give another judge the chance to hear the matter. So the matter has been with her since October 20, 2020. Up to now, the matter is still there and it has not even taken off. We wrote NJC that. But we wrote NJC, I think we submitted the letter to NJC 25th November 2020, asking that the matter should be given to another judge. They replied us 7th April 2021, about 6 months after. So this matter was on when they said they wanted to conduct this, and we now we asked the NIC president, look, this matter, the way it's going, they will conduct the election. And they don't have the power, they don't have the right to conduct any union business again. And that is why we now. So our confidence in NIC, NSC, and various ministers of labor, because various ministers of labor, who's the supervising minister of all trade unions, was reluctant. I'm not really unwilling to call a spade a spade, to tell them that look, this thing is legal. How can it be? They continue to deal with them. Despite our letters, complained that these people stand up and expired, and the knowledge they wanted to rely on has also been terminated. The former national the president of former national leadership was Comrade Ibrahim Khalil, but he died October 2020. Then the comrade Ahmed Labo took over from him. It was Ahmed Labo that conducted the election. Then the colonel that brought in Ambali Akim Olatuji as the president, national president, and other people like that, other national officers. But our own argument is that these people cannot continue to operate the union illegally. And they are not doing that because they have the support of those who that should tell them that go and abide by the rule of law. But like an NSC, supposed to tell them that. But NSC is not even willing. And we are not surprised by that of NSC because it was also a product of the non-legislation in this union, Medical Health Workers Union. So, and we believe that these are the people that are supposed to encourage obedience to the rule of law, but they are the ones discouraging and discouraging that and encouraging impunity. And from the way they behave, you believe that they have support of some people. And that's why they have the audacity to violate court order and do whatever they like. Now, this what they are doing, this audacity and impunity has taken them to Osun State. They went to Osun, they have conducted election. Even when they had injunction, when they have collected injunction that they should not do it, they went and they ordered the cover of the judicial side. They had the order that and they conducted the election in Osun. Now, the strike has been suspended and we are going back to court to raise contempt of court charges against them. Likewise in Oyo State, likewise in Kwara, they will conduct the election. We believe that any election conducted by them is illegal because they don't have the right to do that again. And because we have lost confidence in NSC, and judging from our corresponding with the NIC president, we believe that they are capable of squeezing the matter under the carpet. And more so, the former national leadership keeps on boasting that we remain the court till the kingdom come. And the mantra in their mouth now is that Emma Sejo and Woman Silver, that is, continue to pursue matter in court. We'll be running government, union government. So, and that is what they are doing now. And that, because we are most confident in this people, we want the press, we want the support of the press, especially because you have a lot of confidence around reporters. Because the world will stay by the truth. We are trying some people and we know what they did to us. And that was, please come on. We are not asking for too much, that the matter should be heard. And it's not the hand of justice and way. Let it be hand another judge who is not biased. We are not asking for too much. We are not asking for anything. Here our matter. If a matter a term of 4 years, 6 months have already been wasted on it. And this, in order to support what they are saying, they are saying that we remain but for their first tenure and second tenure. So by the time they spend the two terms, then maybe they will have a need to listen to us. So in order not to give the impression that the last hope of the common man is not the court, we want the press to not to have a passing interest on this matter. We want them to show interest. Let them come up and see, investigate what is going on. What we are saying, we want it to be investigated. There's no statement I make here that I don't have evidence, documentary evidence to support. They need to come and see what is happening in the inter-union crisis that is currently the definite union. Let them come and investigate. And what is it? What is the court doing about it? They want us to remain in court till they cannot come. To us, it is not good to be like that. The court is for everybody. Everybody who brings the matter before the court must be listened to. They should not use any method any urgent guys to cause delay. Justice delayed is justice denied. And this is what we want the press to do for us.
We stand in complete solidarity with the National Caretaker Committee of the Nigerian Union of Local Government Employees, NULGE. Their story is the story of many other campaign workers across the length and breadth of the labor movement today. They have the story of how the leadership of that union, the former national leadership of that union, extended this thing by convening a purported special delegates conference and suspended the constitution in a way similar to that of Hosni Mubarak of Egypt, of all the other dictatorial regime that has suspended constitution and democracy in all parts of the world. We stand for work and for workers' democracy in their unions. And the fact is clear from the plethora of judgments of similar nations from different divisions of the industrial courts that has affirmed the right of the rock and fire workers to own their union. But quite unfortunately, despite the demise of late Comrade Kami, who extended the tenure of that former national leadership, a member of that former national leadership is now purporting himself and parading himself as national president of the union in person of Comrade Ambani. And the reality is this imposed and purported national leadership is parading themselves as national leadership of that union just by the grace of the presidency of the Nigerian Labour Congress. And this is not surprising to us. I think workers and youth across Nigeria would have experienced the bitter taste of compromises, of treachery, of the current presidency of the Nigerian Labour Congress in the person of Comrade Ayuba Oba. What has been holding the life and the oxygen of the current Buhari administration today, the dictatorial regime of Buhari regime today, is only the saving grace of the failure of the national leadership of the NLC to take the next step of calling a general strike. As we speak today, telecom workers are on strike. Workers in Nasarawa State are on strike. Many workers have been laid off in Kaduna State. Yet, the NLC is not taking this step. Just because the cancer that is running deep and eating up NULGE is also the product by which Ayuba Oba came to the presidency of the NLC. He imposed himself on the Miwu leadership and on the Miwu Union and elongated his own tenure and ultimately became president of the NLC through those purported and crooked means. So, as far as we in the MSC are concerned, we support this rank and file building up, rank and file workers' revolts, building up within the labor movement. And we will take this battle to the doorsteps of the bureaucrats, not only in NULGE, but also in the NLC. And ultimately, across the length and breadth of the labor movement. Well, in a congratulatory manner, we in the MSA are celebrating our 1 year anniversary of split from the undemocratic, the former Committee for Workers International. Just as we stand for democracy in the international of the working class, we also stand for democracy in their unions. And as we celebrate our 1 year anniversary yesterday, we are taking off now on another note on our second year, on the note of building a campaign of rank and file workers to defeat our bureaucracy in their unions, and ultimately in the labor centers, and ultimately with the bureaucracy of the ruling class that has held this country down. Life without democracy, it's like a body without oxygen. It will definitely get there. What is killing our country today is the lack of genuine democracy in working class organizations, in the labor movement, and ultimately even in the political space itself. So I appreciate the time. We'll continue this struggle until the very end. Thank you so much.